Hey my friends, how are you doing? Today I'm going to show you how to paint realistic light effects in Affinity Photo. My name is Olivio, I'm a professional designer, and I want to thank all of my patrons who support me and make these videos possible. Also, I want to remind you of my Black Friday Everything bundle deal that is supposed to run out today, but it was really well perceived, so I will prolong the sale until the 3rd December of 2019, which is the next Thursday. And just a quick reminder, what's in there, it's every pro pack for Affinity Photo designer and publisher I created so far, which includes my brush collection, the slideshow designs, the LUT pack with 80 different LUTs, the portrait styles, the landscape styles, the mock-up designs, the autumn styles, and the brand new winter wonderland pack, everything together in one huge bundle for a greatly reduced price. So pick that up until the 3rd December of 2019. Okay, let's get started with the tutorial. So you can see here, this is the after, this is the before. So we made the picture a bit darker and added some beautiful light effects that are coming from the flames over here. By the way, I want to give a shout out to another YouTuber. He's called Benny Productions and he makes really amazing videos. He's working in Photoshop, so I adapted this to Affinity Photo. And you can see here, he's really a master of painting in these light effects. He does it a little bit more extreme. I would say more like in the style you would find in comic books, but also it reminds me of Caravaggio, because this is a very beautiful and classic technique, as you can see here around the edges with the very strong highlights. This brings some drama and contrast to it, also gives it more of a 3D shape. This is a technique also known as chiaroscuro. And if you want to impress your customers and your friends, you can say, we are going to add some chiaroscuro afterwards in Affinity Photo to add some drama and some beautiful light to the picture. Another advice I want to give you is, when you take the picture or download a picture from the internet, make sure that either the light already comes from the right direction, or that you have a picture with a neutral light that doesn't really have a direction. For example, here in this picture, you can clearly see that the light is coming from the upper left side. So it wouldn't make much sense to add highlights and light colors that you paint in and coming from the lower right side, because there is no light there. You, of course, could introduce a artificial second light source afterwards in Affinity Photo, but it's a bit harder to make it look real, so rather follow the natural light that is already in the picture. Okay, so here we have our hand. Let's delete all of the other layers and start fresh. So the first thing I did, of course, was to import a flame. So let's do this real quick. File, place, select the flame. Let's go to downloads. There's the flame. And of course, going to resize that, turn it around in the other direction. And a trick that I'm often using, that you also see in my live streams, by the way, where I use this often, is go over here to the blend ranges, pull down the left side to make the black invisible, and then make a second point, pull it over to the left here on the top side, so you get the lighter areas back like this. Okay, cool. Another trick that I like to often use is now to duplicate this layer, right click, duplicate, and then set it to screen. So it now has like a really light effect, like it's glowing, and then make this layer blurred. So it has kind of this shine around it, has this kind of soft and emotional feeling to it. It's very nice. So the next thing I want to do to bring out the painted in artificial light nicer is to make it more into a night scene. For this, I'm going to create a rectangle. So here on the left side, choose the rectangle tool, draw a rectangle over all of the picture. The reason why I use a rectangle is because then with the gradient tool, I can adjust the gradient afterwards as often as I want. Let's send the blend mode to soft light like this, and then we have here our gradient. You can take these handles here, move them around, put them wherever you want, and you can up here, when you click on this, you can set the colors. So when you look at this here, let's put this down again a little bit. When you look at this, I'm not going to use a very bright orange because this would give me too much light and then I wouldn't see the highlights I paint in as well. So I'm going to use a darker orange for that, so we just get a hint of the orange light coming from the flames. And of course, the rest is a darker blue that is, of course, giving us the night effect. So I set this to radial as the type for the gradient and then just put the gradient up here in the corner. And you can see we can resize it to decide how long or how far a distance should the orange light go. I will set it so it's going until here, and then from here onwards to the outside of the picture, we have nice blue light. Good. So how do we paint the hand? What we want to do, first of all, is we are going to create an adjustment layer for recolor, and you want to put this on top of your rectangle that you created before with the gradient, so it's not influenced by that color change of the soft light blend. With that done, what we're going to do is to adjust the hand to an orange and also to a brightness that looks like the light of the flames are shining onto the hand. We can, of course, readjust this later on, which is also a good idea, because it will be a little bit different after you have painted it in. What we're going to do now is, with our recolor adjustment layer selected, we're going to go to layer and then to invert, so it's not visible anymore. I'm going to use my selection brush tool and I'm going to go and make a quick selection of my hand. Keep in mind that we mostly only need the right side of the hand where the light is coming from. The selection on the left side is not that important actually in this case. So just to point that out. Also, of course, the darker areas are not that important because we want to paint in the highlights onto our hand. Good. Okay, so we have done this. Let's click on refine. We have to do some readjustments down here, for example. This didn't work out very well. So we need to brush over these parts a little bit better. Okay, that didn't work. Ah, there's a hand in here. Okay, that's good. So that's okay. Let's go to the parts up here. Paint over this a little bit so we get a better selection. And I think we're almost done. Like I said, we don't need to have the left side selected too precisely. Doesn't matter. You can also, by the way, use the lasso tool if you have shapes that are inside of the body and where you don't have a clear edge like here. Use the lasso tool and then use feather to make the edges of the selection a little bit softer. Okay, I think this should be all right. Now we can use a basic brush. Make sure that you go on more and set the spacing very low, like maybe to 1 or 2%, like this. And then also reduce the hardness. Sorry for the noise from outside. I want to reduce the opacity so I can stroke over it multiple times. So go to 25%, then make the brush bigger. And this is a benefit of the selection. I can have a nice big brush so the light is coming on rather softly here. Good. So what we need to do now is to select black and white as our two colors. And you can see already when I have it as at white and I go over here, I can already see that this is painting in a little bit of light. Let's maybe make this a little bit brighter here. And you can see now I can now paint in here where I think there should be light on the hand, like that. Also over here a little bit and down here and maybe also here a little bit, like that. Here, of course, on the thumb we need some light. That's what's maybe a little bit too much. Let's go with the black color. We can paint it out again, of course, so we can also go in here where we think there was a little bit too much of it on our hands. You can see this is because the hand is just thin tubes. This is a bit easier to do. Let's go to white again and make the brush a little bit smaller. So you can see here, like in the area where it's flat, it's pretty hard to actually assess where we should have light, where we shouldn't have light. Click some more on here. Good. Press Ctrl D to deselect. You can see now we have some nice light effects on the hand. A thing that I like to do to make this more intense is that I duplicate now the effect and set the second one to screen. So again, we have this kind of glowing effect, and now you can reduce the opacity. For example, set one of them to 50% and the other one to 50% too. So you can really adjust how strong the light should be, if you want the light to be more intense or rather soft. You can play around with that. Like I said, it takes some exercise to actually make it look good, make it look realistic. Okay, that was the tutorial for today. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon. Bye.